are you, and how did you find me?
Well? Once there were four children whose names were Peter, Susan, Edmund, and Lucy. They were sent away from London during the war because of the air raids. They were sent to the house of an old professor who lived in the heart of the country, 10 miles from the nearest railway station and 2 miles from the nearest post office. He had no wife, and he lived in a very large house with a housekeeper called Mrs. MacCready. He himself was a very old man with shaggy white hair, which grew over most of his face, as well as on his head.
He has a nice face. He looks a lot like you.
Ha! But on the first evening when he came out to meet them at the front door, he was so odd-looking that Lucy, who was the youngest, was a little afraid of him. A few mornings later, Peter and Edmund had just finished their breakfast with the professor and were upstairs in the room he had set apart for them. A long, low room with two windows looking out in one direction and two in another. When the two girls rushed into the room and said, "I'm going to explore in the house." Everyone agreed to this, and that was how the adventures began. This house of the professor's, which even he knew so little about, was so old and famous that people from all over England used to come and ask permission to see over it. It was the sort of house that is mentioned in guidebooks and even in histories. And well it might be, for all manner of stories were told about it, some of them even stranger than the one I am telling you now. And when parties of sightseers arrived and asked to see the house, the professor always gave them permission. And Mrs. MacCready, the housekeeper, showed them round, telling them about the pictures and the armor and the rare books in the library. Mrs. MacCready was not fond of children and did not like to be interrupted when she was telling visitors all the things she knew. She had said to Susan and Peter almost on the first morning, along with a good many other instructions, "And please remember, you're to keep out of the way whenever I'm taking a party over the house." Just as if any of us would want to waste half the morning trailing round with a crowd of strange grown-ups, said Edmund, and the other three thought the same. Anyway, it was the sort of house that you never seemed to come to the end of, and it was full of unexpected places. The first few doors they tried led only into spare bedrooms, as everyone had expected they would. But soon they came to a very long room full of pictures, and there they found a suit of armor. And after that was a room all hung with green, with a harp in one corner. And then came 3 steps down and 5 steps up, and then a kind of little upstairs hall, and a door that led out onto a balcony, and then a whole series of rooms that led into each other and were lined with books. And shortly after that, they looked into a room that was quite empty, except for one big wardrobe, the sort that has a looking glass in the door. There was nothing else in the room at all, except a dead blue bottle on the windowsill.
"Nothing there," said Peter. "Not much good coming here."
What is this? Said Peter, stooping down. He had just noticed a piece of paper.
Did someone leave a note?
Is there anything written on it?
Is there a message on it?
Yes, there is,
answered Peter. But I can't read it in this light. Let's get out into the open air. They all went out in the daylight.
That's much better.
And crowded round Peter as he read out the following words.